Kurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission, registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Educational Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12th, contact 9025895176. Metric, 6 to 12th, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
Hello students, we are discussing differential equation, miscellaneous exercise problems. Question number 6, find the general solution of differential equation dy by dx plus square root of 1 minus y square upon 1 minus x square equal to 0. Okay, now I have to find general solution of this differential equation. Now what is given differential equation? Dy upon dx plus square root of 1 minus x square upon 1 minus y square upon 1 minus x square equal to 0. I will write this term this side. So what we have, dy upon dx is equal to minus of square root of 1 minus y square upon square root of 1 minus x square. Okay, I will write this term this side and dx this side. So what we have, dy upon square root of 1 minus y square is equal to minus of dx upon square root of 1 minus x square. Okay, up to here, variable separation completed. All y terms and dy one side, all x terms and dx other side. Integrating on both sides. Integrating on both sides. Okay, so what we have, integral dy upon square root of 1 minus y square is equal to minus of integral dx upon square root of 1 minus x square. Okay. Now, integral dy upon square root of 1 minus y square is sine inverse of y. So, sine inverse of y is equal to here minus. This is also same. Integral dx upon square root of 1 minus x square is sine inverse of x. So, what we have, sine inverse of y is equal to minus sine inverse of x plus c. Okay, right? Minus term this side. So, we get the final answer as sine inverse x plus sine inverse y is equal to c. Okay. What we have here, what is given differential equation? Given differential equation is dy upon dx plus square root of 1 minus y square upon 1 plus 1 minus x square. Write this term this side. Okay, we have this step. Write square root of 1 minus y square this side and dx this side. So, what we have, dy upon square root of 1 minus y square is equal to minus dx upon square root of 1 minus x square. All y terms and dy one side, all x terms and dx other side. Integrating on both sides. So, what we have, integral dy upon square root of 1 minus y square is equal to minus integral dx upon square root of 1 minus x square. Okay. Integral dy upon square root of 1 minus y square formula is sine inverse y. Okay. Direct integration formula, sine inverse y, right hand side, sine inverse x. So, sine inverse y equal to minus sine inverse x plus c, right minus term this side. We have sine inverse x plus sine inverse y is equal to c. Okay, sin inverse x plus sin inverse y equal to c, that is the general solution of given differential equation. Okay, next question. Question number 8, find equation of the curve passing through 0, 4, 0, π/4. Find the equation of curve passing through 0, π/4 whose differential equation is sin x cos y dx plus cos x sin y dy equal to 0. Find the equation of curve passing through 0, π/4, equation of curve passing through the point 0, π/4 whose differential equation is sin x cos y dx plus cos x sin y dy equal to 0. Okay, what is the given differential equation? Given differential equation is sin x cos y dx plus cos x sin y dy equal to 0. I'll mark this one as 1. Okay, I'll write this term this side. So what we have, sin x cos y dx is equal to minus cos x sin y dy. Okay, now Now I'll try to write all x terms and dx one side, all y terms and dy another side. Now here with this y term I'll write this side, this x term I'll write this side, or else divide both sides by cos x cos y. Okay, that also we can do. Okay, now what we have, if you write cos y this side and cos x this side, sin x upon cos x dx equal to minus of sin y upon cos y dy. Okay, writing all x terms and dx one side, all y terms and dy other side. Up to here what we have, all x terms and dx one side, all y terms and dy one side, integrating on both sides. So integral sin x upon cos x dx is equal to integral minus sin y upon cos y dy. Integral tan x dx is what? Log mod secant x. Log mod secant x is equal to minus outside integral sin y upon cos y. Integral tan y dy is log mod secant y. So minus this minus one, minus log mod secant y plus c. Okay, minus term write this side. So what we get, log mod secant x plus log mod secant y is equal to log c. Log a plus log b, log a b we can write, no? So log secant x into secant y is equal to log c. Okay, log m is equal to log n, then m is equal to n. Using that property, so what we have, secant x into secant y is equal to c. Secant x into secant y is equal to c. Mark this one as 2. What is given? Given curve is passing through the point 0 comma pi by 4. Passing through the given curve is passing through the point 0 comma pi by 4. Substitute x value 0 and y value pi by 4 in equation 2. So what we get, secant 0 into secant pi by 4 is equal to c. Okay, so secant 0 is 1, secant pi by 4 is root 2. So c value is how much? Root 2. Substitute c value in 2. So what we get, secant x into secant y is equal to root 2. Okay, right, root 2 this side and secant y this side. So what we get, cos y is equal to secant x upon root 2, which is the required equation of curve, which is the required equation of curve. Okay, now here question is to find the equation of curve passing through the point 0 comma pi by 4, whose differential equation is sin x cos y dx plus cos x sin y dy equal to 0. Okay, now here we'll apply variable separable method, means we'll write all x terms and dx one side, all y terms and dy one side. For this, write this term this side, divide both sides by cos x cos y. So what we have, sin x upon cos x dx equal to minus sin y upon cos y dy. Okay, so tan x dx equal to minus tan y dy, integrating on both sides. So integral tan x dx is equal to minus integral tan y dy. Okay, integral of tan x dx is log mod secant x. So log mod secant x is equal to minus log mod secant y plus log c, right, minus term this side. Log mod secant x plus log mod secant y is equal to log c. Log a plus log b, log a b, that is log of secant x into secant y is equal to log c. Okay, now log m is equal to log n, m is equal to n. So secant x secant y is equal to c. Given the curve is passing through the point 0 comma pi by 4, substitute in place of x 0 in place of y pi by 4, we get c value as root 2. Substitute root 2 in equation 2. So what we get, secant x into secant y is equal to root 2, or else cos y is equal to, right, secant y this side and root 2 this side. So cos y is equal to secant x upon root 2, which is the required equation of the curve. Okay, next question. Next question, question number 9, find the particular solution of differential equation 1 plus e power 2x dy plus 1 plus y square into e power x dx equal to 0. Given y value is 1 when x value 0. Okay, now find general solution, substitute x value 0 and y value 1 to find particular solution. So what is given equation of curve, given differential equation? 1 plus e power 2x dy plus 1 plus y square into e power x dx is equal to 0. Okay, I'll write this term this side. So what we get, 1 plus e power 2x into dy is equal to minus of 1 plus y square into e power x dx. Okay, 1 plus e power 2x I'll write this side, and 1 plus y square I will write this side. So what we have, 1 upon 1 plus y square dy is equal to minus e power x upon 1 plus e power 2x dx. Now all y terms and dy one side, all x terms and dx other side. Okay, now up to here variable separation part completed, integrating on both sides, integrating on both sides. So what we have, integral dy upon 1 plus y square is equal to minus integral e power x upon 1 plus e power 2x, I'll write like this, 1 plus e power x whole square dx. For right hand side integration, for this right hand side, what I will do is I will put e power x is equal to t. What is the advantage? E power x is equal to t means e power x dx is equal to dt. E power x dx is equal to dt. So entire numerator part becomes dt, denominator part is 1 plus t square. So integral right hand side reduces to integral dt upon 1 plus t square. This minus as it is. So what we have, integral dy upon 1 plus y square is equal to minus integral dt upon 1 plus t square. So integral 1 upon 1 plus x square dx is tan inverse x. So using that formula, integral dy upon 1 plus y square is tan inverse y is equal to minus tan inverse t plus c. Okay, so minus term right this side, tan inverse y plus tan inverse c is equal to tan inverse y plus tan inverse t is equal to c. Okay, what is t? Ma, t is e power x, no? So what we have, tan inverse y plus tan inverse e power x is equal to c. What is given here? Ma, up to here general solution completed. To find particular solution, we have to find the value of c. What is given? Given y value is 1 when x value is 0. Okay, given y value is 1 when x value is 0. Means in place of x will substitute 0, in place of y will substitute 1 in equation 1. So what we get, tan inverse of 1, y value 1, no, tan inverse of 1 plus tan inverse of e power 0 as x value is 0 is equal to c. My e power 0 is how much? 1. So tan inverse of 1 plus tan inverse of 1. Tan inverse of 1 is how much? Pi by 4. So pi by 4 plus pi by 4 is pi by 2. So c value is pi by 2. Okay, substitute c value pi by 2 in equation 1. So what we have, tan inverse of y plus tan inverse of e power x is equal to pi by 2. That is the particular solution of given differential equation. Now here, what method we are following? Variable separation method. Then we are integrating. So what is given differential equation? 1 plus e power 2x dy plus 1 plus y square into e power x dx is equal to 0. Write this term this side. So we have 1 plus e power 2x into dy is equal to minus of 1 plus y square into e power x dx. Write y term this side and this x term this side. So it reduces to 1 upon 1 plus y square dy is equal to minus e power x upon 1 plus e power 2x dx. All y terms dy one side, all x terms and dx other side, integrating on both sides. Okay, left hand side direct integration formula, integral 1 upon 1 plus y square dy is tan inverse y. Okay, left hand side. Okay, right hand side, what we have, minus integral e power x dx upon 1 plus e power 2x. Okay, that I'll write as minus of e power x dx upon 1 plus e power x square, and I'll put e power x is equal to t, e power x dx is dt. So right hand side reduces to minus integral dt upon 1 plus t square. So this integration value is minus tan inverse t. So tan inverse y is equal to minus tan inverse t plus c. Minus term right this side, tan inverse y plus tan inverse t is equal to c. What is t? T is e power x, no? So tan inverse y plus t times tan inverse y plus tan inverse t equal to c. T value is e power x. So we have tan inverse y plus tan inverse e power x is equal to c. Okay. Now up to here general solution part completed. Now to find particular solution, further information given that y value is 1 when x value is 0. Means in place of x substitute 0, in place of y substitute 1 in equation 1. So tan inverse of 1 plus tan inverse of e power 0. X value 0, e power 0 is 1. So tan inverse of 1 plus tan inverse of 1 is equal to c. Tan inverse of 1 is pi by 4. So pi by 4 plus pi by 4 is pi by 2. C value is pi by 2. Substitute c value in equation 1. So what we have, tan inverse y plus tan inverse e power x is equal to pi by 2. Okay. My next question. Question number 10. Solve the differential equation y into e power x upon y dx is equal to x plus x into e power x upon y plus y square into dy. Okay, here y is not equal to 0. If you write dy by dx form, dy by dx, what you get, dy by dx is equal to y e power x by y upon x e power x by y plus y square. But that is not a homogeneous method or a variable separation method. Okay, so what we will do, what we will do here is here I'll write dy this side. I'll write dy this side. So what we have? What we have? Y into e power x upon y into dx upon dy is equal to x e power x upon y plus y square. Okay? Now write this term this side. So what we get? Y e power x upon y into dx upon dy minus x e power x upon y is equal to y square. So from these two terms we can take e power x by y common. So e power x by y into y into dx upon dy minus x is equal to y square. Y square if you cross multiply this side by y square is equal to 1. Okay, I'll mark this one as 1. Okay, now here I'll put e power x upon y as some variable z. Okay, let e power x upon y is equal to some variable z. Here what we have dx upon dy, no? Dx upon dy we have, so I'll differentiate with respect to y, not with respect to x. Because here in 1 we have dx upon dy form, so I'll differentiate with respect to y, not with respect to x. So differentiate with respect to x on both sides. So what we get? Right hand side dz upon dy, left hand side d by dy of e power x upon y. So derivative of e power x with respect to x is e power x only. So dy by d by dy of e power x upon y is e power x derivative e power x only, no? So e power x upon y. By chain rule we have to differentiate x upon y. So d by dy of x upon y. Okay, but derivative of u by v, derivative of u by v is what? Vu dash minus uv dash upon v square. So e power x upon y into y into x derivative with respect to y dx upon dy minus x into y derivative with respect to y 1 upon y square. And this is the derivative of u by v formula. Okay, v means y into x derivative with respect to y dx upon dy minus x into y derivative with respect to y 1 upon v square, nothing but y square is equal to dz upon dy. Okay, I'll mark this one as 2. Mark this one as 2. Now if you observe from 1 and 2 left hand side of 1 and left hand side of 2 both are same only, no? So from 1 and 2 what we can write? Dz upon dy is equal to 1 we can write, no? From 1 and 2 dz upon dy is equal to 1. So dz is equal to dy. Dz is equal to dy. Integral dz is equal to integral dy. Now what we have from 1 and 2? Left hand sides are equal. So I'll equate right hand side. Dz upon dy is equal to 1. So write dy this side. So what we have? Dz is equal to dy. Now dz is equal to dy. All z terms and dz one side. All y terms and dy one side. Variable separation part completed. Integrating on both sides. So integral dz is equal to integral dy. Integral dz is what? Z is equal to integral dy is what? Y plus c. What is z? Z is e power x upon y. So e power x upon y is equal to y plus c. Okay, that is the solution of given differential equation. That is the solution of given differential equation. Okay. I'll repeat once again. Here given differential equation is y into e power x upon y into dy dx upon dy is equal to x e power x upon y plus y square. Okay, right, this term this side. So what we have? Y into e power x upon y into dx upon dy minus x into e power x upon y is equal to y square. Take e power x upon y common and cross multiply y square this side. So e power x upon y into y into dx upon dy minus x upon y square is equal to 1. Okay, now I'll put e power x upon y as z. Now differentiate with respect to y, not with respect to z, because here we have dx upon dy form. Okay, so differentiate with respect to y. So what we get? Right hand side direct dz upon dy, left hand side e power theta derivative with respect to theta is e power theta. So e power theta into, by chain rule we have to differentiate x upon y. Okay, d by dy of x upon y. Here uv rule if we apply, what we get? E power x upon y into dx upon dy minus x into dy upon dy upon dy upon y square is equal to dz upon dy. Now if you compare 1 and 2, left hand side of 1 and left hand side of 2 both are equal, so we will equate right hand sides. So dz upon dy is equal to 1, dz is equal to dy. Okay, up to here variable separation part completed. Integrating on both sides, integral dz is equal to integral dy. So z is equal to y plus c. Okay, what is z? E power x upon y. So what is the solution? E power x upon y is equal to y plus 11th question. Find a particular solution of differential equation x minus y into dx plus dy plus x minus y into dx plus dy is equal to dx minus dy, given y value is minus 1 when x value is 0, y value is minus 1 when x value is 0. Okay. Here, first of all, I'll multiply dx here and dy here. So, what we get x minus y into dx plus x minus y into dy is equal to dx minus dy. Okay, write minus dy this side, it will be plus dy and this term this side. So, that all dy terms one side and dx terms other side. So, what we have x minus y into dy plus dy is equal to dx minus of x minus y into dx. Okay, dy common. So, 1 plus x minus y into dy is equal to 1 minus of x minus y into dx. Okay, write dx this side and this term this side. So, what we have dy upon dx is equal to 1 minus of x minus y upon 1 plus of x minus y. Okay, mark this one as 1. But this differential equation is not a directly variable separable method. It is this differential equation is reducible to variable separable method. Up to here you cannot write all x terms and dx one side, all y terms and dy one side. This is directly not a variable separable method. So what I will do, this is reducible to variable separable method. So what we'll do here is, whenever you have something like this, function of x minus y is function of x comma y, okay, or x plus y, something like that, you put this part as some variable, okay, let it be t, okay, put x minus y is equal to t, x minus y is equal to t, okay. Now differentiate with respect to x on both sides. So what we get, differentiate with respect to x on both sides. So what we get, left hand side, x derivative with respect to x is 1 minus y derivative with respect to x, dy by dx is equal to right hand side dt by dx. Okay, I'll write dt by dx this side and dy by dx this side. So what we have, 1 minus dt by dx is equal to dy by dx. Well, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. Now substituting 2 and 3 in 1 means, in place of dy by dx write 1 minus dt by dx, in place of x minus y write t. So 1 reduces to, in place of dy by dx what we'll write, dy by dx is replaced by 1 minus dt by dx is equal to right hand side 1 minus t by 1 plus t. So 1 minus of x minus y is t we consider, no? So 1 minus t by 1 plus t. Okay, write dt by dx this side, dt by dx this side and this term this side. So what we have, 1 minus of 1 minus t upon 1 plus t is equal to dt by dx. Okay, take LCM. Okay, so what we get, dt by dx is equal to 1 plus t minus of 1 minus t upon 1 plus t. Here 1 minus 1 cancel, t minus of minus plus t, t plus t 2t. So dt upon dx is equal to 2t upon 1 plus t. Okay, write t terms this side and dx this side. So what we get, 1 plus t upon t, 1 plus t upon t dt is equal to 2 dx. Now here if you observe, all t terms one side, dt one, all t terms and dt one side, all dx and x terms one side. Okay, now up to here variable separable part completed, variable separable part completed. Now integrating on both sides. So 1 by t plus t by t is 1. So integral 1 by t plus 1 dt is equal to 2 times of integral dx. Now integral 1 by t dt is what? Log mod t. Okay, log mod t plus integral 1 dt is nothing but t. Okay, log mod t plus t is equal to 2 times of integral dx is x, no? So 2x plus c. Okay, what is t? T is x minus y. T is x minus y. So log mod x minus y plus x minus y is equal to 2x plus c. 2x plus c. Right, x minus y this side, it will be minus x plus y, no? So 2x minus x is x plus y plus c. So log mod x minus y is equal to x plus y plus c. Okay, mark this one as 4. up to here general solution part completed, up to here general solution part completed. To find out particular solution, what is given is y value is minus 1 when x value is 0. So in place of x substitute 0, in place of y substitute minus 1. Okay, so what we get? Log mod 0 minus half minus plus 1, 0 plus 1, 1, log mod 1, or log 1 is 0, left hand side is 0, right hand side 0 minus 1 plus c. 0 minus 1 is minus 1, minus 1 plus c is equal to 0, so c is equal to what? 1. C is equal to 1. Substitute c is equal to 1 in equation 4. So what we get? Log mod x minus y is equal to x plus y plus 1. X plus y plus 1. Okay, this is the particular solution of given differential equation. Okay, this is the particular solution of given differential equation. Okay, I'll repeat once again. What is given differential equation here? Given differential equation is x minus y into dx plus dy is equal to dx minus dy. Okay, multiply x minus y inside here. Here, so what we get? X minus y into dx plus x minus y into dy is equal to dx minus dy. Okay, write dy this side and dx term this side. So what we have? X minus y into dy plus dy is equal to dx minus half x minus y into dx. Okay, now take dy common. Up to here all dy terms one side, all dx terms one side. Take dy common here, dx common here. So what we have? 1 plus x minus y into dy is equal to 1 minus of x minus y dx. Write dx this side and this term this side. We have dy upon dx is equal to 1 minus of x minus y upon 1 plus x minus y. Mark this one as 1. But this is not a directly variable separable method. This is reducible to variable separable method. Okay. We cannot apply here homogeneous also. This is not a homogeneous function. It is not a homogeneous function. Moreover, it is not a linear differential equation also. Okay. It is reducible to variable separable method. For this, what we'll do, we'll put x minus y is equal to t, differentiate with respect to x on both sides. So what we get? Dy by dx is equal to 1 minus dt by dx. Okay, substitute 2 and 3 in equation 1. So what we get? 1 minus dt by dx is equal to 1 minus t upon 1 plus t. Write this term this side and this term this side. Okay, so what we have? Dt upon dx is equal to 1 plus t minus of 1 minus t. Okay, 1 minus 1 cancel, 2t upon 1 plus t. Dt upon dx equal to 2t upon 1 plus t. Write t terms this side and dx this side. So what we have? This denominator comes here, numerator. Numerator comes here in denominator. 1 plus t upon t dt is equal to 2dx. Integrating on both sides. So here 1 upon t plus t upon t is 1. Integral 1 upon t plus 1 dt is equal to 2 times of integral dx. This is log mod t plus t. Integral 1 by t dt is log mod t, no? Integral dt is t is equal to 2, integral dx is x, 2x plus c. Okay. Now, what is t? X minus y. X minus y, log mod x minus y plus x minus y is equal to 2x plus c. Write x minus y this side. So, log mod x minus y is equal to 2x minus x plus y plus c. Okay. So, x plus y plus c. Log mod x minus y is equal to x plus y plus c. Okay. Now, y value is minus 1 when x value is 0. Okay. Now, substitute in place of x 0, in place of y 1, we got c value as 1. Substitute c value back in 4, we will get the solution, particular solution. Log mod x minus y is equal to x plus y plus 1. Okay.